Here is your first foray into iOS development, and I'm going to start you out with something we call control flow. One way to control the flow of code in our app is with an if statement. In Swift, if statements are easy to use and understand with a minimal amount of code to type. Here's how it works. It starts with the keyword if, and then a statement that you expect to be true, following by opening curly braces. The closing curly braces finish off the if. Inside the if statement, you can put the code that you want to run if that statement evaluates to true. Some say change is the only constant thing in life. What if we want to run some code if the statement is not true? Enter the else clause. Right after the closing curly brace of the if, we add the keyword else and another set of curly braces. In there, we have code we want to run if the statement evaluates to false. There are other types of control flows in Swift, including a very powerful switch statement that we will cover later on in this nano degree. In fact, we even have an elective course called Swift Syntax that takes you into all the ins and outs of the Swift language. Now, let's move on to Xcode. In Xcode, open the quizviewcontroller.swift file. In Project Zero, I've pulled out most of the code into something we call a class extension, just so you can focus on the few lines of code you need to write. Scroll down until you see the @ibactionfunc flag button pressed function. This function is called when the user presses one of the three flag buttons. We need to see if the user pressed the correct button and then display a message to them. How to do this? An if statement will work great. The variable that this function is given when called is named sender. By the way, you will hear people use the phrase passed in. It just means the variable sent to a function when it is called. Sender is an object representing the button pressed by the user. All buttons have an integer tag, and we have also stored the correct tag under the variable called correctButtonTag. So let me walk you through this. We know the correct tag is stored under a variable called correctButtonTag. We know we just got passed an object corresponding to the button that was pressed as a parameter to this function called sender. So we need to check if the tag of the button that is passed is the same as the correctButtonTag. In other words, we need to check whether the user pressed the right button and picked the correct language. Here is the if statement that you need to add to this. The double equals is a comparison checking to see if the passed in buttons tag is the same as the correct button tag. If it is, great. Tell the user they chose the correct answer. If the tag integer values do not line up, the answer was incorrect and we should inform the user as well. With this if statement added, we should be able to run the app and see what happens when we choose an answer.